What's up, what's going on, people of YouTube? It's your boy M. Lee, here to give you guys an unboxing slash overview slash first test of the Ion Tailgater, the remodel version of the first original one that came out with a while back. They got a lot of different models of this speaker. They got the Tailgater, the block rocker, and they got another one. They also got different models of those models. So they got like the one that you can fit the iPad inside there. They got the one with the wheels on it. Got the one that lasts a little bit longer. The one with the lights flashing on it and stuff like that. But I just got the Tailgater. It's gonna be used for my music video shoots. You know, that's the first thing. It was the first speaker I had when I started doing music videos. I got the old one, which I'm gonna show you guys. Shout out to everybody that's been watching my videos and stuff like that as far as the speakers is concerned. Ever since I made that unboxing video, the very first one, go ahead and pop that up on screen. Even to this day, I still get comments and still get views and everything like that. People ask me questions, if it's still working. It died on me after, I think, a year and a half to 2 years, so it lasts for a pretty decent time. The reason why is because, like the manufacturers say, if you drain the battery completely, then that's when you're gonna start having issues. The unit itself is gonna have difficulties charging and stuff like that. I also had made a video of the old unit as well on YouTube talking about, you know, my issues with it, and I had brought an external charger since the unit wasn't charging the battery no more. I brought an external charger to charge the battery, you know, manually, and that worked for a little bit. Then, you know, the battery just kept dying after like 5 minutes of use. So this bad boy right here, let's go ahead and dig into this unboxing. That's what y'all wanna see. So this bad boy right here, I don't know why my camera keeps trying to focus on my workbench, but this bad boy right here says that it's, you know, 50 watt peak power, 50 hours plus a battery life. You know, I couldn't believe that when I read that. Big step up from the first one. I think the first one was like 7 or 8 hours or 9, somewhere around there. Microphone included, just like the first one. USB charging port. Did it have? Yeah, it had that. I think it had that. No, it didn't have the USB charging port, so that's new. 100 foot Bluetooth range. That's real good for my music video. So if I'm off, I got this. If I'm, you know, on my crane, I got the speaker like more further up or something like that, I don't have to worry about it cutting out and stuff. So 100 feet is actually pretty good. You know, it's my first time doing this video, doing a video like this, you know, with me capturing my B-roll plus the main shot at the same time. Fresh off work, so, you know, I'm still trying to deliver the energy and the type of unboxing I like to do for you guys and stuff like that. You guys like my, you know, my new way of doing my unboxing. I'm trying to do stuff different. Gotta be different than everybody else, or else ain't no point in watching my unboxing. You gotta be watching my Yelp. So here we go right here. We got some, got the wires and everything like that. Hopefully this camera getting focused. You know, that's the, got the charging cord. Excuse me, I'm sick. So if I'm coughing in the video, I'm sorry ahead of time. But here it is right here. Oh, and I brought this from Walmart, as you can see from the title already. Bought it from Walmart. It's $119.99, but I got my 10% off, so it paid for the tax and then some. So that's what I love about, you know, working at Walmart. At least you get that little 10% off, so whatever you buy is exactly what it is without the tax, and then you get some money off on top of that. It comes with an auxiliary cord, you know, focusing on that. It comes with auxiliary, paperwork and stuff like that. Maybe that niche chop. And the microphone. Wish I still had my other one, but I had lost it. Or I had left it somewhere. Never went back to go pick it up because I was being too lazy. But here's the microphone. Decent, you know, nothing super spectacular. You know, this whole unit's $120. I mean, come on now, what do you expect? But you know, you don't expect no studio mic, do you? But you know, it's decent for what it is, you know, just, you know, doing my little stuff, you know, whatever you want to do, karaoke or whatever, family game nights, you know, play the games on the projector and then, you know, do a little karaoke, you know? Yeah. So, I'm going to attach this big ass foam thing up out of here. And surprisingly, when I was carrying a box out of the store, I didn't use a shopping cart. It's lighter than the first unit, if I'm not mistaken, because I was like carrying this thing with no issue. Normally, after the first like 30 seconds, your arms start to talk to you like, bruh, like, are you serious right now with this heavy ass thing? You about to switch hands or get it to the other hand or something, boy, you tripping. But anyways, go ahead and take this bad boy out the box. Thumbs up for the fact that I'm off work, working 8 hours a day, overnight. This is early in the morning right now, y'all. So I'm gonna disturb my neighbors. It's a duplex, so you know, they like very next, directly next door. Thumbs up for me being fresh off work. Overnight stocking the pets department. You know what I'm saying? All right. Make sure both of my cameras still recording, because I be hating that, man. One camera ain't, or I'm not recording the whole time. I'm doing some good ass commentary, and then after that, I try and redo it. And I'm just like, oh man, it's messed up the whole thing. So I got a little bit of plastic on top. Do a little side by side. Try and get this side, both the cameras and stuff like that. So you guys can see it right there. Y'all see that? You know, y'all should be able to see that. All right, what side I'm putting myself on? Put myself on this side. So, okay, I'm looking the right way, you know. So the back, now on the back of the original one, it has the lights to let you know, to indicate how much battery power you got left, you know. And it has the on and off switch, the power light, to let you know what's going on, if it's on or not. And also it has the original iPod dock at the top, so you can dock your iPod up here and stuff like that. If you got the original iPod, if you got a you know, iPod to iPhone dongle, you can attach that right there up top, and it plays your music directly off of that. Excuse me. But on here, it has an LCD screen on the front that's gonna show your battery life and stuff like that. So you don't have to worry about looking at the back. You can actually be right there on the front. Let's go ahead and turn it around to the front. Let me look at the weight. Let me see. And this is the battery in the side here, and it weighs the same amount, kind of. Yeah, pretty much the same amount. And that's without the battery inside here. I got the battery out of it. So on here, the wire sticks up, the black wire comes up right there. On here, it has like a little groove that the wire sits in, or the antenna, well, I'm saying wire, and it's silver, you know, that comes up, you know, for your AM, FM radio, you know. So this one feels more smoother, maybe because this is old, but this one feels more smoother, of course, because it's brand new. It has some grooves right here, you know, for, I think you can set some stuff on top of here, probably, it can't really hold no iPad, really. It's like, I don't know why they got these grooves, but you can set stuff inside here to set it up on there and stuff like that. So that's pretty good. It's been plenty of times where I was filming, I was filming a music video, and I didn't have nowhere to sit my phone because I had the phone attached, you know, through the auxiliary cord. So it's like the speaker would be on. I had to have my phone sitting right here, and sometimes it'll fall off. This has like a little, you know, cradle. I like when companies remodel stuff and they do little things. Like, the little things make big differences. Some of y'all inside relationships need to realize that. Ain't nobody looking for nothing spectacular. I'm looking for little things. A girl that can do little things, but that's a whole different topic. Anyways, take this off. I've got the piano black on the knee-zobs and stuff like that. You know, feel real smooth. Let's see how it feels compared to the other one. This is the mic volume right here, the master volume. They both feel smooth. This one, even though it's old, it still feels smooth, you know, compared to this one. This one just feels more loose. These are more loose. This is the same amount of smoothness, but more like stiff. So right here is how you turn on the radio, you know, bam, go to FM and then AM. On the old one, it's the old one. Even got my MD film sticker up here at the top. Then you can tune it right here, the little buttons to tune it back and forth. Got the two right and left auxiliary jacks right here, microphone inputs right there on the old one. And now I got this back screwed on, so this keep coming off. But anyways, let's go ahead and take this old one off. Let's see how the handles feel compared to. So on the new one, the handles are more deep, you know, they like dig in more, stuff like that. So let's go ahead and set this down. Also on the old one, it has like the metal corners. These have plastic corners. I don't know, I mean, might not make that big of a difference really. You know, this have rubber feet at the bottom, some decent sized rubber feet. Let me check the rubber feet on here real fast. They're pretty much the same rubber feet. So right here you have your auxiliary, you have your mic input. You only have one mic input on this one. On the other one, on the old one, you have two mic inputs. On this one, you only have one. I'm gonna turn my microphone around since I'm talking over here. So you only have one on this one. You have Bluetooth, the Bluetooth button right here. You know that you guys see that. Got a Bluetooth button. You have the radio button, so you press that to turn on the radio, I'm assuming. This is how I'm the type of dude that don't look at directions. I'm just like that. I be figuring out stuff like that. That's the whole fun of it. But this is how you search and stuff, seek for different radio stations. And I think this is the volume. No, this is the volume, obviously. But this is how you seek. And, you know, play button right here. So that's that. Oh, here's the USB charging port right here, USB Bambi. And here's some more plastic. I think I'm gonna leave that plastic on there for a little bit, for about a good month or so, and take it off. So let's go ahead and see if this bad boy has some juice inside of it. All right, so here's the first test. Turn it on. I got my iPhone Sexy right here. And on. Yep. Shows that it has full battery power. Full battery. I'm going to play like about a few songs, about 3 or 4 songs, you know. Test out the microphone as well, like I did inside my first video about 3 years ago. Like I said, again, shout out to everybody who's been watching that video, because probably you're watching right now and you probably watched that old video too. We're trying to buy a speaker. So you watched that one, now you're watching this one. So, you know, thank you. So first, let's test out the speaker. I mean, the microphone. Let's just go ahead and test out the microphone first. This thing on. Check one, check two, baby. You know, so here's the microphone right here. Got it set to the max volume on the microphone. I can also adjust the master volume to turn up the mic as well, I believe. If it's, you know, there we go. Yep, so we can, you know, down the smell. I found, dang, camera talk. I sound smooth inside this bad boy, boy. All right, okay. Sounds smoother beside this bad boy. Hey, baby girl, what's your name, is girl? What's going on, baby? What? Bring your ass over here, girl. It's like, nah. Actually, let me test it out again. It's pretty smooth. It got a little bit of bass inside of it, so I like that, because, you know, I got that little soft-spoken voice. That's when you get on my bad side, and that's a whole different story. But, you know, I got that soft-spoken voice, but not no Michael Jackson type soft-spoken, so at least I got that. So that's the microphone for you. Pretty decent, actually. I think it sound better than the old one. I wish it had 2 auxiliary jacks, you know, for, you know, doing karaoke. There's some, you know, basic karaoke and stuff like that. That'd have been cool. So let's see how hard it is to attach this bad boy to Bluetooth. So, you know how Bluetooth works. You're supposed to hold down the Bluetooth button to let me turn on my go to my Bluetooth settings real fast, see if it detects it, because I'm holding down the Bluetooth and, well, yeah, Emily, that's why you read the directions. Well, I don't read directions unless it's something I gotta put together, and that's a whole different story. So it's searching right now. Let me see if it's gonna find this without tailgater right there. See, it's going to look at the phone real fast. See that, but tailgater, click on that. Let's see if it's gonna sync, if it's gonna connect. Okay, connected. Okay, excuse the hell out of me, baby. All right, so first I'm gonna test out one of my songs right here by Jamie Foxx. I've been listening to a lot, you know. Song is knocking. Let's see. Oh, first name pause this. Let me let you know that my volume on my microphone is set to automatic. So when I cut this up, it's not going to actually get louder. It's not going to get that much louder, because the microphone and the camera are going to automatically adjust for the loud volume. So you're not going to be able to hear me talk if I talk during it. That's how you know it's loud. But it's not going to sound loud on YouTube unless I turn my microphone on manual, which I would do, but it's not really a big deal. But it's not going to sound super loud on YouTube. Just know that. I'm liking the bass already.
I really need to see you, babe. Tell me when you're on your way. I'll roll one up for you, babe. Roll one up for you, babe. I've been really missing your body. Sex so good, like, oh my god. I know you like it when you're on top. Do it, babe, do it, don't stop.
Let me stop. I ain't gonna go there. Let me stop. I ain't gonna go there. But no, it sound good, man. It sound real good. You know, to be honest with you, the bass sound good. That speaker sounded good, but I just turned this all the way up, and it don't have that distortion like that one does. That one has a little bit of distortion when you turn it all the way up, which, you know, it's understandable. It's a $100 speaker like this one is. That was the same price that this one was when that one first came out. So I'm so glad that they remodeled it and have it the same price as the other one when it first came out. And Now I'm gonna beat it like a drum. Beat it like a drum. Beat it. Bum, 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 bum.
That you don't tonight.
Girl, I really don't want much of you. Look me in my eyes while I'm touching you. Look me in my eyes while I'm touching you. Look me in my eyes while I'm touching you. Roll on a young clip for tonight. Kissing them places, I know you lie. Kissing them places, I know you lie.
Places, I know
you lie. Let's take a champagne shower. In the tub for an hour. In the tub for an hour.
In the tub for an hour.
Girl, you know you're my sweetheart.
Hope that I didn't take it too far.
Wah, wah.
I hope that you don't take
it. Oh yeah, I know I gotta do this. Oh yeah, I gotta cut this all the way up real fast and hear that bass on this song. Man, inside my headphones, my Skullcandy headphones, when this song come on, oh my God, dude, that's the, man. Oh, that's that off the whole little move. Hold on. Let me start that. See how it handles the bass, because this is some demanding bass right here.
James.
It handles it all right. Not too well, but it handles it pretty good.
Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it.
It's 2 o'clock and I'm faded. This cush feeling amazing. Got a voicemail on my phone from a little breezy feeling X-rated. She told me that she had me. I'm in the car and I'm swerving. I walked into her bedroom. I put it down, that's something. And I stay on that survival. I stay taking shots. Hey, you girl, be on my job. And everything in line.
See, I ain't no bitch nigga, no bitch nigga, no snitch nigga. I'm a real nigga.
And that's a real nigga.
I'm just trying to chill.
Cause I'm way too drunk to be talking like this. I'm way too high to be tripping like this. Way too young to be living like this. Ask me what I do and I'ma put it like this. God damn it,
I love it.
I love it, baby. I love it, baby. I love it.
God damn it, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it.
So I'ma keep on drinking cause I love this shit. And I'ma keep on smoking cause I love this shit. And I'ma keep grinding cause I love this shit. She tell me keep on getting love this shit. I love it.
So that was just a little test, an overview, unboxing, whatever, whole full video of my impressions of the Ion, the new Ion. Well, it's not all that new, it's been out for a while, but it's new in my opinion, you know, as far as the old one, the new Ion Tailgater. like I said, I like it a little somewhat. It's not an LCD screen, but it can pass for one. It's kind of like those clocks, those little alarm digital clocks. So that's how it is. I like the fact that it's 50 hours. I gotta test that theory though. Maybe 50 hours with the music down low. I like how easy it is to connect the Bluetooth. I didn't have to even hold down the button, I don't believe, but there is a Bluetooth button right there. So I like the little cradle right here so you can just put your phone down, especially if you got it plugged up through an auxiliary, or you can just have it inside your pocket if you got it in Bluetooth, because that's what I'm gonna be doing, you know, skipping back and forth through the songs and stuff like that for the music artists. Another thing I hated about that speaker, it only had auxiliary only, so I had to keep on going back to the speaker, pressing play, and hurry up and picking back up my camera and stuff like that. It's like now I can just bam, or just have somebody just, you know, whatever. So I really, really love this cradle right here. So if you do want to leave your phone up here, I like the antenna. I like how that is, the little groove, the little little built-in thing, majigger, how the whatever. What else? I like the knobs. The knobs are smooth, like the first one. I wish it had 2 microphone inputs, but I like the clarity of the microphone. The microphone is kind of deep. I wish it had like kind of like more of a flat sound instead of like that super bass sounding. But like I said, it's only $120, so what can you ask for? This play, let me see what this play button is. I wonder if I can actually play my song. Okay, hold on. Okay, so I can stop. start the song, you know. Wait, hold on. Start. But like I said, I got the phone in my pocket. I got somebody, you know, working with me that I hired, or I got my son with me or something like that. And I don't feel like taking my phone out the pocket. I got all my camera gear on me, with me and stuff like that, and ready to shoot. I can just tell him press play on the speaker thing, and he can just go right to it. Play. Hail Mary. So, yeah, man. What else? Oh, let me see if I can skip back and forth through the songs. Oh, yeah. One of them brand new big boy toys. You know what? I'm going to the club this weekend for sure. I don't care what nobody's like. I get my dance. I haven't been to the club for a long time. I get my dance on, boy. But this is actually my my playlist for my skating playlist when I go out skating and stuff like that. So I have songs like this and stuff. You know, getting it in the skating ring. This But I hate going skating, though, because when I go skating, it makes me want to go to the club because I can't really dance inside skates like that. And I'm like, no, let me take these skates off. Show you what I got. Go over here, girl, and show you. Break it off something real quick. But nah, but anyways, thank you guys for watching this unboxing overview video. Any questions you guys have, let me know. If this video, if you're looking at the date of this video and somehow it's later on, like a year later, and you want to know if it's still good, don't hesitate to ask me and stuff like that. I will answer as soon as possible. So I'm enjoying it so far. The weight isn't all that bad. Pretty much the same weight as the other one, probably a little bit lighter. And hopefully this don't have the same issues as the first one, where once the battery is drained completely, it messes up the circuitry within the unit and stuff like that, stops it from charging and pretty much working even with it plugged in. You know, some people still was working with it plugged in. But anyways, enough of all that lollygagging. The video already went on long. So with that said, people of YouTube, it's been your boy M. Lee. Let me look at the bottom of it. That's why I didn't look at it yet. The complete bottom of it. Okay, yeah, so it's the same as the first one where you can slide the battery out if you want to. So yeah, man, it's been your boy M. Lee, and I'm out. Peace.